Welcome back. We're going to play a little set with just the guests who've been invited here this week. So please welcome again from South Australia, it's Julian Ferrer on the violin. And the saxophone and everything else. Adam Page. I thought a South Australian boy. He was born in Melbourne, then he moved to Adelaide for a long time, and now we've got him back. That's Nick Mulligan on trombone. My name's Joss Hill. This is Greg Tenekoff on the piano here. Paul Jankovic on the bass. And John McDermott on the drums. John McDermott. I'm sure some of you have already picked up, and there's one guest you haven't met yet tonight. Very special guest, very excited to have her here with us. She's someone that I've known for many years and worked with a lot, and one of my dear friends, and she is a superstar. And you're about to hear from her. Please welcome to the stage, Miss Emma Pask.
I'm a sucker, I'll have to be. Thank you. together, shall we? We are going to play one more little tune before we bring the fabulous students back to join us on stage. We're going to blow out another tune called Sister Sadie.
I'll follow you back. Try to keep up.
Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, Emma Pask.
I feel like I should see more of a choir up here. It's now time to bring the students back on stage. We're going to be joined by Vocal Jazz 2, under the leadership of Jane Edwards. We had a great time over there, and we'll tell you a little bit more about that. They're going to perform a tune called Boy from New York City. But we can talk about all the good times you guys had together. All right.
To brush up this tune, and gosh, I was pretty impressed when I first met you all and I heard it. And I've been having fun. I think many of you, maybe if you're any fans of the wonderful Manhattan Transfer, you probably would have heard this tune before. These girls are going to tell you all about the boy from New York City. All the mums in the audience are like, one day, mums, they may head to New York. I'll encourage them to do so. Okay. I've been rehearsing today and the other days with my back to you guys that you weren't here, so I've been doing this. I've been having so much fun looking at their faces, and now I'm in the mode to really do that, but I won't do that to you. I may just do a mixture of both. How can you not look at them? They're so lovely. Yeah. Okay, let's do it. You can. Thank you, Will.
Thanks, Jane. Lovely.
I think we're going to have another beautiful choir on the stage, is that correct? We're going to do a little George Gershwin for you. You girls are going to file on, girls and guys. One of the great musicals, Porgy and Bess. This is a song that I know you're going to know, but perhaps you've not quite heard it like these guys are going to do it for you tonight. It is, of course, Gershwin's Sometime. It's going to feature the wonderful Adam and Julian coming back to the stage. Thank you. We're going to strip things back again to Vocal Jazz 1, led by the gorgeous Jess here, ladies and gentlemen. She also has been doing beautiful work with the girls, and Ross and I are going to join you guys for a beautiful song that was written by Johnny Mandel. It was the theme from that beautiful movie, Sandpiper, and it's called The Shadow of Your Smile.
We'll color.
think we're moving to Big Band now, perhaps. I think I've suddenly turned into the MC of the evening too. You guys okay with it? He's gonna try and take over even though I don't know what part's going on. No, we are gonna do Big Band one. Moving from one movie to the next, I believe. I mentioned that was, of course, to Chenevier's smile from the beautiful Sandpiper. We're going to move back in time to about 1939, to a beautiful movie called The Wizard of Oz, and the wonderful Miss Judy Garland certainly made this song famous, with her beautiful rendition of Over the Rainbow.
And I'm loved above.
got this job as MC. What's next? Oh, I haven't had some fun. I believe. Not that we haven't been having a lot of fun already. We're going to have some more fun.
Just got a couple of numbers to finish up with, and it's fantastic that we've got, I think, almost everyone on stage, and equally as good that we're going to be joined by our Year 6-7 choir, Vox Pops, who are going to come along tonight and sing Purple Rain, and also a Bowie medley to finish up with. Vox Pops are directed by Miss Elena Harrison, and in a few weeks, they're going on tour, and Elena's produced a really tremendous program for them, which involves dance and a bit of technology and a whole range of things, so I'm sure they'll have lots of fun. So, and as well as that, we've got our string section back. So it's a bit like the 1930s, you know, big band with the strings, and all of our special guests, and of course, Yin Yin. So, this first piece obviously is a tribute to Prince, and Prince not only was an amazing artist, but he wrote a lot of music for a lot of other people. So we're going to try and pay tribute to Prince with Purple Rain.
Yeah!
We've come to the final piece of the night. There we go. We've come to the final piece of the night. When Dex first got in touch with us and talked about all the different ideas he had for this this event and this concert, he said it's going to be a tribute to legends. And specifically, you know, for most of the night, to fallen legends, because there were so many in the last year. So we sat down. Where was that? Oh, it's kind of a joke. I'm not trying to, it's not a trap. And I can't remember what we were having a chat and we were raving about. It was at dinner in that Thai restaurant in that suburb in Adelaide. And
we were home very early.
Yes.
We didn't eat much food, or we certainly didn't drink any wine.
No. So we spent some time talking about it, and we said that a really amazing thing. We cannot do tribute to the fallen without, and we've already heard a little bit of it tonight, but without paying tribute to my favourite androgynous alien pop star, David Bowie. And so we talked about a Bowie suite and to arrange it for basically as many people as we could fit on the stage. And I thought about it for a while, and we talked about, you know, our favourite Bowie records and songs that would be great from Ziggy Stardust and from Diamond Dolls and there's all these different things, and there's so many great tunes. And then I thought, wouldn't it be great to, my favourite Bowie record, which is the name of this concert, is Hunky Dory. And it's just wall-to-wall genius. And I thought it would be great to when I started putting this thing together, it ended up just being all songs from Hunky Dory, because I love that album so much. And then it became the name of the concert. So this is a suite I wrote specifically for these guys and specifically for our soloists. And I'd just like to say from Emma and myself and Adam and Julian and Nick, we've had such an amazing time this week at Westminster with pretty much, you know, a bunch of legends. They're pretty amazing kids, and we've had a lot of fun. And the kids have been super respectful and energetic and giving with their sort of energy and receiving our energy as well of, you know, what we want to offer. And it's been really special. So thank you guys for having us from us, because, yeah, we've had it all. And it's been really exciting. Most of the time with these things, you come in for the afternoon, you do one rehearsal, and then you do the concert. So to actually come and spend time with these students and be able to have, you know, multiple chats, and, you know, and there's been wonderful things, Lockie coming up to Adam asking questions, and people coming up to Emma asking questions, and all that sort of stuff. It's wonderful to have that relationship and develop a connection with the students. So we're going to have a ball on this one and let it all hang out, and it'll... It's, do I need to say what songs are in it, or can we just roll? Okay, so Changes have to be there, because it's one of the great track one, side ones of all time. There's a wonderful song from the middle of the record called Kooks, and then we're going to finish with the greatest chorus of all time, Life on Mars. So thank you so much for having us, and thanks Mike for putting on such an amazing thing and having such a beautiful program.
Thank you. Thank you. so much. Just a couple of very, very quick thank yous, but there's been a lot of people that have made this possible. The Friends of Music and Performing Arts, and Mike and Mick and Sound and Lighting, and the MMC Tech Crew, AJS Sound and Lighting, Donna and Cheryl at the front, our patrons and sponsors, all of our music staff, our ensemble directors, accompanists and musicians, Darren and Lachlan, to Jack and Union, and thank you all so much for coming along. We don't do this without an audience, and it just makes it, so really appreciate it, love the support. How about these students? Fantastic.
Well done, John.
We rehearsed very economically.
So to put something together like this was done in a relatively short space of time, so that's amazing. I just do want to thank, the stuff that you heard tonight, a lot of it was original stuff that was arranged by these guys, and to be able to do that, they just say, oh yeah, we can do that, and it'll take a few hours. It's just incredible. That skill is amazing, and you just heard evidence of that. That arrangement that Ross did was just wonderful. It's great to play, and it's a great finale, and Ross, mate, that's just amazing. Can we give Ross all we can? Also, to the other special guests, what's been really, really good about this week is so much learning. I've learned so much, but what I liked really was watching these guys interact with each other, and we sort of picked up on all that. Some of it was disgusting, but it was just fantastic. It was fantastic to see how they interact and get on with each other, and it just makes it. So, Nick Miner on trombone. Adam Page on everything. My ex student, Julian Ferretta on violin. And Emma Pass on vocals. Thanks very much, everyone. We've had a great time. We hope you've enjoyed it, and stay tuned for next year, because Music Night won't be on the same night as the Crows game. So, well, thanks for giving that up if you have. We'll just leave you with the last little bit of this. Lucas, what do you reckon? Better sit down, strength.